consumer. The realistic the objective statement, the external statement. So in this case, actually, your objective seems confusing. You're supposed to put it this as a justification, but it shouldn't be a statement. Okay, and then now your timeline, your action plan. Again, this is not the format that requested. This is not the Gantt chart, and this is not the way how you're supposed to present your action plan. I now like to, I need you to answer a few questions or help me to clarify the doubt that I have. Your plan should be start in 1st of April, but all your dates that you plan ahead will be from July and onwards. Should be able to answer my question.
Because I have the 1 year period, so I'm supposed to start from the July.
Then why, what is the purpose to set the plan okay from April, but whatever actions will be only implemented in July? So what are you going to do with the 3 months? The first 3 months, what are you going to do? And justify that. You cannot justify the 3 months, right? And this is a 1 year plan. It's supposed to be end in March 2020. But please look at your plan. It will be only end in December. So we're showing that instead of 1 year plan, this is just a half year plan. 6 month plan. Am I right? And also for the below graph chart, July 01, what is this 01 means? First is a date or the year? 1st of July. So this also show is a half year plan. So this plan is not aligned with what your objective inside. This is achievable because the company could expand more retail shop and outlets in Asian country, right? So this is one of your reasons to justify the 5% of annual revenue could be achievable. Okay, and then now come back to your action plan. What is your market extension? What is your store extension? You do not know what is the purpose to come up this action plan because it is nothing reflected your objective. Anything else you want to clarify?